What's going on YouTube world? Austin here, coming to you guys with another YouTube video. And in this video, I'm gonna be breaking down the steps, the tips and tricks, the shortcuts for you to actually go out there and start your very own ATM business. Now, before I even start this video and kind of get into the nitty and gritty, if you're watching right now, and you've always wanted passive income, or you've been interested in learning how to get passive income, I highly recommend you stay to the very end of this video, because I was just like you a couple years ago. In fact, I was sitting in your same spot watching the same kind of individual teach me how to get some sort of passive income. Ladies and gentlemen, over the short couple of years, my partner and I have been able to scale an ATM business to well over 100 ATM machines, and not only that, been able to teach hundreds upon hundreds of individuals how to do exactly the same thing. Let's dive right into it. Before I jump into it, make sure if you guys are brand new here, smash the thumbs up button if you guys are still watching. If you guys are brand new here as well, then make sure and subscribe. Come check out some of my other videos. I do a lot of ATMs. I do a lot of passive income, real estate, business, all sorts of such. And if you guys have any recommendations on videos you guys would like to see, then drop in the comment section below. Without further ado, let's jump right into it. What do you need? What are the necessary steps that you need to take in order to actually start your very own ATM business? Let's start with number one. Number one is you're gonna need an LLC. That's right, you're gonna have to go to your corporate commission, get an LLC. Is it recommended to do it immediately? Not always, but I always recommend individuals follow the immediate steps. That way, you have your mind in the right place. So the first step is to get an LLC. My recommendations for those of you that are gonna go do this, don't put the word ATM anywhere inside of that LLC, because when you go to hand over the paperwork to a business bank account or a bank, they are gonna see that you put ATM on your LLC. And as you guys might know, banks are not a very fond fan of the ATM business. Moving on to the next one is you guys are actually gonna need a business checking account. So obviously you guys have your LLC. My recommendation for those of you that are gonna go open up a business bank account and not put it in your guys' personal checking is go to your local bank. I don't recommend going to a higher authority of branch like a Wells Fargo or a Chase or of a Bank of America. Nothing wrong with these banks. It's just that these banks just typically don't put the okay on the ATM business. Think about it. You are going into the bank, pulling out loads of cash, and walking out of the bank with loads of cash. Therefore, they don't like however many times the money is being recycled. So go to a local bank, a smaller credit union or something rather another, share with them that you're getting into the ATM business, and hopefully you guys have the best of luck doing that. Number three for you guys is you actually gotta find an ATM company that you wanna do processing with. Now, I know that finding an ATM company is definitely not easy. It's not something I recommend individuals to Google. And I always recommend, just how I said, not going with a larger company, not going with a larger company in terms of a bank, but not going with a larger company in terms of purchasing and doing processing with your ATM. And the reason being is because larger processing companies, I'm not even gonna name names, what they typically do is they undercharge you for the ATM and overcharge you for the processing. Now, most people don't even realize that they get bound inside of a contract with an ATM company for 4 years or 2 years, and then they're stuck. Once they got that good deal on that ATM and realized that X amount of cents are gonna be taken out of their surcharge profits and they got $15, $20 a month fees for back office things, I'm not saying that's wrong, I'm just saying there's other ATM companies that you don't have that. Once they realize that and have signed their life away, they're almost stuck inside that agreement. So I recommend when you are looking for an ATM company that is interested in actually doing processing for you and with you, that you at least like, trust, and respect them. I recommend calling us the different companies, speaking with the owners or speaking with the sales reps. You typically won't get the owners, but speaking with the sales reps, or if you guys are interested in working with us, we can certainly help you as well. All you got to do is just shoot me an Instagram DM or email me below, which my email will be below. Just say, hey, Austin, I want to hop on the phone with you and talk to you about processing with my ATM. We are always happy to help. So that would be number three. Number four would be getting your contracts dialed in. What most people don't realize is that you need a contract when you go to land a location. Now, what I mean by that and why I share that with you is because if you don't have a contract with a location and you just have a handshake, then chances are that handshake won't last very long. Where if you have a contract that says, hey, for a minimum of 3 years, I'm gonna have my ATM inside your establishment, I'm gonna service it, I'm gonna load it, I'm gonna maintenance it, I'm gonna do all of the heavy lifting work, and you don't have to do anything, that is gonna be worth much more to you than just a handshake. Getting a lawyer, getting your attorney to draft you up some sort of contract. Again, if you join our course below, it comes with our contracts, which works in all 50 states. But again, that is not a sales pitch. That is just if you guys are interested. Once you have a contract, the next step would be getting a location. I have other videos on my channel that allow you to take a look at what businesses are gonna be like your A and B kind of businesses, and then your C and D kind of businesses. And that all that really scaling was the rating from which businesses are better, what salons, which areas, what bars, what restaurants are better for you to put inside your ATM. That way you can create that cash flow. Once you found that location and you got them to sign with your contract, obviously you have an ATM company that you're now gonna be working with, that you've expressed to them that you wanna order an ATM. You order your ATM, and then obviously you need an installer. Once you guys find an installer, which you can look on multiple different areas. I know some companies allow people to install for them depending on the situation. I know some companies charge $300-$400 to install your ATM machine. What you can actually do is you can actually go to your local handyman. Go to your local handyman and ask him to install your ATM and tell him that you're gonna be installing a lot of ATMs in your area and that you're gonna use him over and over again. Once you guys have your ATM installed in that location, then just gonna simply profit. Ladies and gentlemen, the maintenance on an ATM machine is actually not too difficult. It is not a lot of work to maintenance this machine. Once your ATM is installed, you then gotta put cash inside of it. My recommendation for those of you that put your ATM inside of a new business is put $2,000 inside that ATM. Now, obviously, that just solely depends on how often it is that you wanna fill your ATM machine. If you wanna fill it more times, you can put less money. If you wanna fill it less times, you're gonna need to put more money. Ladies and gentlemen, set that surcharge to $3 or $4, and from there, you just cha-ching, you profit. That was the simple steps. Those were the simple how-to steps on actually starting your very own ATM business. Now, if you guys have any questions, make sure and drop in the comment section below. Make sure and email me below or come over to my Instagram and shoot me an Instagram DM and ask your questions. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a free Facebook in the link in the description below as well that allows you to join the Facebook group where nothing but ATMs is talked. My partner and I actually started an A&A show. This link will also be in the description below. It is a show that allows you to have some motivation and some entertainment. So I recommend you guys definitely going and checking that out, making sure you can subscribe to the channel. We are bringing all sorts of incredible guests on there. Anthony, Josh Snow, John Malott, all sorts of incredible business men and women, wealth of wealth on that channel. So make sure and go check that out. And again, if you guys are still here right now, I just wanna say thank you. I wanna make sure that you guys smash the thumbs up on this video. Make sure if you guys haven't already and subscribe to the channel. Share this video with 5 of your friends. Austin Lewis here saying, we'll see you guys in some future videos.